Hello and welcome to Jay's Crochet and Knit Gifts. Today we are going to be learning different stitches, and I made up different swatches of them. During this whole thing, this video thing that I'm doing, I just want to bring up front is that I'm a beginner. I am no expert. I'm still learning. I picked up this craft of this art about 3 months ago. I was in a severe auto accident in March of 2016, and my whole world changed. It's been a good growing experience, very humbling. So I couldn't go to the gym anymore. I couldn't be in the yard anymore, and being new to a new state, a new city, I was going crazy. So I picked up a hobby that I feared. I needed to overcome a fear with everything that I'm going through. So I knew how to knit. My beautiful grandmother who had passed, she taught me that. But I never knew how to crochet. And my sister did. And she made some really beautiful scarves for me and a beautiful hat. And I wanted to learn, but I feared it. I was scared. So I had made the goal to learn, and the way I learned was watching videos. I'm a very visual learner. Some people are a book learner. There are different types of way of learning, and I'm now learning to understand patterns, and I'm creating my own patterns, my own designs, and it's not going to happen overnight. It's going to be a new experience every day, just like life. This to me is a step in my life. So I want to share this with you. I would love you to ask me questions, and if I don't know the answer, we'll find out. We'll find out together, or I'll find out and we'll learn. We'll learn together. So I would like to welcome you to this page, and enjoy learning with me. I'm very blessed. So, first of all, I'm in my room here in El Paso, Texas, and I just more or less threw it together. It has a work in progress, but all my yarn and all my stuff. But I share it with my babies. I have 6 babies, 3 cats and 3 dogs, and they all have been rescued. Periodically during the filming, you might hear them. I have 3 cats. Sir Charles, who's the oldest, he's my black and white cat. He's very, very timid. I love him. And then you have Maxwell Amadeus. He is all black. He looks like a black panther. He weighs about 20 pounds, heavy cat. And then our new addition is Simba. We just got him in February of this year from El Paso at the Humane Society. He is a rescue Maine Coon. Oh my goodness, he is a kid. Oh, playful. He's still trying to fit in a little bit, you know. Charles have accepted him. Maxwell is like, I don't know about you, dude, but they're great. Now we're going to move on to my dogs. Ray and I have 3 beautiful dogs. The first one that came into my life is Blues, Miss Blues. She's beautiful. She is my guardian. She watches over me. She's almost like my therapy dog. She knows when I'm not feeling well, I'm having a rough day, the pain level really high. She senses that, and she lays real close with me. She's beautiful. Both of them are a gift that came into my life, her and Ray. The next baby that came into Ray's and our lives is Miss Luna. Luna is a personality of no other. She will tell you how it is and how it's going to be. I think she's half Rat Terrier and half Chihuahua. I have no idea, but she has her mood. She is just a dream. I love her. She reminds me of a teenager in a way. Then we have Soul. This is Daddy's boy. He is full Chihuahua. We're thinking he came from Chihuahua, Mexico, which is about 10-15 miles away from us. He's been saved, and I'm gonna tell you, he has had a hard life. You could tell in his demeanor and the way he interacts, but he's warming up. He is just entering. So the other dogs are slowly but surely accepting him. Moving on periodically through these videos, I'm going to share a little bit about my life and what has occurred in my life, and hopefully it helps you. You know, this is building skills and building each other up. So again, we're going to be learning the different stitches, and if you have any questions, just make a comment. I will do my best. If anyone knows me, I'll do my best. So now we're going to be learning the different stitches. I'm going to move my camera down so you see them, what I'm saying. There are different stitches, different patterns, different things, and different needles, as we learned in the other, or hooks, I apologize, hooks that are you can use or that are requested for the different patterns. The G from the other one. So I do have my hooks out for you all. So from there, from any pattern or anything that you make, ranging from scarves to blankets, to hats, to doilies, anything. I have this little doily here. You're going to start the chain, and these chains are going to look like this. I'm going to show you how to make these very, very, very soon. So this is going to be considered your chain stitch. It's your beginning stitch. This is your building block. You got to have a foundation. Anytime you build a home or when you build something, you got to have a hardy foundation. So we will learn how to do our chains. But this is what the chain stitch is going to look like. I'm not sure if you're able to see that. Hold on just for a second. I apologize. There, that might be a little better. I'll stop moving back and forth and get you some seasick. So that's what that looks like. So the next stitch that you will be learning will be the slip stitch. It's more of a, it's an ending stitch, if that makes sense, finishing off or ending a row situation, to identify the two. Here, this is going to be your chain here on the very, very bottom. I don't know if you're able to see this, but here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and so on. Here is going to be your, you know what? I had that backwards. Your slip knot. Okay, here's your slip knot. Here's your chain. So, here's 1, 2, and there 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4. And we'll go more. That's going to confuse you. Boy, I'm sorry. But here's your chain. Here's your slip knot up here, if you're able to see that. Your single crochet, which is a single one of the stitches that different patterns will ask for. This is a sample. I had used a 4-weighted yarn. If you've seen one of my other videos, this is my sample yarn. Anytime I try something new, this is what I use. So I made my chain down here. This is your chain, because this is my, you know, this is where my hook would go into, right here. So I chained, and then I did my slip knot. I have 2-3 rows here. And here's your different chains. I'm going to pick up my row. Okay. So then on the next one, a lot of my projects that I make is going to be with a half double crochet. You know what? I need to do a double crochet. That is what I'm missing. I have the half double crochet. I'm missing my double crochet. I will make one of those up soon. This is my half double crochet. I love this stitch. It's the woven look to it. It's just gorgeous to me. It reminds me of crosses for some reason. Here again is your chain. And this is going to be your chain here for you. Now we have the triple. Here is going to be your triple, which is bigger. Here we have your triple, your chain up there for you. Okay, and then you're going to learn from also the front loop and also the back loop. This here is going to be the front loop. Here is your chain right here, and we take the hook and we go in the front loop, and here's the stitch. It almost looks like a stockinette stitch. If you knit or if you see a shirt, I don't think I have it on mine. You have the stockinette around the edging of your shirt or your arms here. That is going to be the front, and this is going to be the back. Here's your chain here, and there's your stitch there. So you have your, it's going to be in the back. The stitches will be in the back. The next thing that I had learned is I just love this. I had watched one of these videos. Oh my goodness, it's just, it was beautiful in the color. And I was really afraid that I wasn't going to be able to work it out. But this is the woven stitch. As you can tell, I was practicing. And then I tried the woven. You know, you got to build up your courage. So this here is the woven stitch. It is just beautiful. And you'll learn how to do that. It is just beautiful stitch. It's like two stitches in one. It's just gorgeous. So you'll learn how to do that. Also, you'll learn how to do circle or round. You have flowers. You can do hearts. I mean, there's a lot of things. Make hats. I mean, I've tried two different kinds of styles of hats. I'm still really trying to get down the circle stitches. It's I don't know why, but it's hard. I don't know why I make it hard. But yeah, that will be my next. And then, just to give you an idea, I had a video on the different hooks, and here's my double crochet I did. Oh my goodness. We're only getting younger, ladies and gentlemen. Here's my double crochet. I'm going to show you guys the difference. This is my front and back loop. It's my triple. And this is going to be the half double crochet, and this will be the double crochet. I don't know if you're able to see the difference of that. It's not as big. Whoops, excuse me, I apologize. It's not as big. I can do that in the stitching there. In the half double crochet, it's a little big. There's going to be a little bit more work, a little bit more yarn usage in that. Kind of how it would be the right terminology. But yeah, this is your double crochet. This is your half double crochet. I love this stitch. So, oh, amen, I don't have to make that. Blessed. The next thing I wanted to show you, what did I do with it? My half, I just had it. We'll make another one. The different size of hooks is going to give you different sizes of the project. That's one thing I want you to remember, is the smaller the hook, the smaller the project. You might ask for a hook that size, and if you want to make the size a little smaller to fit a smaller person, you might have to downsize. This is a J hook right here. This is an F hook. Your J hook is going to be bigger. I don't know if you're able to see that. Hold on. There you go. It's going to be a little bigger. And then your F will be much smaller in the stitches, if you're able to see that. Like that. Another thing that I had practice on that I wanted to learn was people use plastic hooks, or they use metal hooks, or they use bamboo hooks. I've not got a set of bamboo. There's a pink metal set that I really, really want, but that will be a waiting time. Okay, metal. Half double. That's in my double crochet. KKKP. Okay, so for example, I missed one. This is going to be a K plastic hook here. If you can see that. This is going to be a K metal hook. I love my K hook. I'm always using it. So for example, this is my K hook here for this hook. And my plastic for my K is going to be this. I wanted to show you, using a plastic plastic against a metal, the differences of it. Hold on, I pulled a little bit, so I don't want you to think that one's smaller than the other. There is a difference. I mean, there is a little difference in there. I don't know what it is. Believe it or not, it's the same chain. It's same size hook. It's just, I think the metal is tighter. Maybe my tension was tighter. It's a learning process. That's another thing. When you hear the word, the terminology, if you watch these videos about tension, it's the strength that you pull on your yarn. And I will show you. I'm pretty casual on my tension. I don't like a lot of tension on my yarn. It makes my hands sore at the end and tired. And getting older, you know, I've never had problems with my wrists. I'm very, very, very blessed on that. But your hands do get tired through the process. So it just gives you a little idea of the different patterns, the knowing what the single crochet looks like, the slip knot and stuff like that. My next video will be learning how to do the chain again. I would like to say thank you for visiting. If you like it, hit like. If you don't hit don't. If you want to subscribe, hit subscribe. You know, I'm just learning. We can learn together. And I want you to always remember you are making a difference today. Thank you. And have a beautiful day. And thank you again from Jay's Crochet and Knit Gifts. Thank you.